Now that you have a introduction to annuities and annuity deals, let's look at a few more examples. In this example, we are going to be finding the payment instead of the future value or the present value. This is a relatively practical problem. Let's say you want to borrow $20,000 for a new car, and the interest rate is going to be 8%. You have to make monthly payment, therefore the interest is compounded on a monthly basis. You're going to take out a four-year loan. What is your monthly payment? So this is a really practical problem. So we know that our goal is to find the payment. So let's draw the timeline. So we know that this loan is going to last 4 years. This is a 4 year loan. However, we have to make payment monthly. So we know that this is a monthly problem. So 4 year loan times 12 months per year. That means we'll have to make 48 payments altogether. We know the interest rate is 8%. So that's also relatively easy. So our interest rate is 8% per year, but we are making payment on a monthly basis. So our interest rate is 8% divided by 12. The main question we have is the $20,000. Should we know that we are finding the monthly payment? So that's what we are looking for. However, is the $20,000 the present value or the future value of this annuity? So I'll let you pause the video for a minute and think about that question. The best way to think about it is to think of if you go to the car dealer, will the car dealer let you walk out with the car without paying? And the answer obviously is no. So in other words, even if you're taking out a loan, the car dealer wants the money today. So if you're taking out a loan, what happens is the bank gives the car dealer the cash today and you drive away with the car, and then in return you make monthly payments to the bank. So this is a very common loan problem. Most loan problem, the present value or the loan amount is oftentimes the present value. So the present value in this case is $20,000. Now we have all the information we need. We can compute the payment. So again, when I use my calculator, I'm going to check that this is in the cash flow is set as at the ending mode for ordinary annuity. I'll reset the calculator by clearing TVM. Here we have present value is $20,000. I'll keep that as positive, because the bank is literally giving me the money to hand over to the car dealer. Interest rate is 8 divided by 12. So you can enter that in one period. So that is our interest rate. And our investment horizon is 48 months. And we are computing the payment. So in here, it actually makes sense. Our payment will be cash flow is $488 per month for this car pay for this car. Fantastic. Now let's take a look at another example. In this case, we're going to look for the number of payments. Let's say you have borrowed $2,000 at 5%, and you're going to make annual payment of $734. The question asks, how long will it take before you pay off this loan? So let's look at the information that we have. So what we don't know is the duration of this loan. So a question mark actually goes on here. We have no idea how long it will take. We do know that the payment frequency is monthly. I'm sorry, it's annually, so it's per year. So we borrow $2,000. So the amount that we borrow is typically the present value. So we put down present value of $2,000. And you are paying back annual payment, so we'll make that a negative outflow. So you're paying back $434.42. And you do that every single year. So this occur more than once. So how long does it take before you pay off the loan? So in this case, we have a present value of $2,000, and our payment amount is minus $734.42. In this case, the inflow versus outflow assumption is very important because we are solving for the number of period. So we'll make our loan amount, the $2,000 in inflow, and the payment amount, the negative $734.42 in inflow. We know that the interest rate is 5% per year. And we are computing the investment horizon or the loan duration. So let's clear our calculator. Again, I use second function clear TVM. This is very important when we are working with annuities. Our present value is $2,000. So present value, and our payment is $734.42. So we make that an outflow. That's our payment. 5% is our interest rate, and we are computing the number of period. So this loan is exactly 3 years. Now that you're familiar with annuities, we have this new tool that help us address additional finance problem. So let's take a look at one more example. Let's say you go to a car dealer and they give you this fantastic deal. It's $10,000. You borrow $10,000 from your parents, and they say you need to pay $207 per month for 16 months. They ask, what is the interest rate that your parents is actually charging you? So again, let's take a look at how this problem will look like. So the $1,000, we are quite familiar with this now. The $1,000 is the loan amount. So the loan amount is the present value. And we typically make that positive. We need to pay this back. So that's our annual payment. So our payment amount is $207.58, and we'll make that our cash outflow. This loan is gonna last for 60 months, and you are asked to find the interest rate. Okay. So as I said, that's relatively straightforward. Let's jump right to the calculator to solve this problem. So reset your calculator or clear all your register. We entered $10,000 loan, $207.58. Again, we make that an outflow. That's our payment. This loan will last for 60 months. And we are computing the interest rate. So parents is charging you 0.7499%. That's the interest rate per month. So in this case, we have found the answer. However, sometimes the interest rate more often is stated on a per year basis rather than on a per month basis. So if you are asked to find the interest rate on a per year basis, if it is 0.7499% per month, that translates into approximately 9% per year. Now let's take a look at a more realistic example. So we have mastered a lot of tools for the time value of money and basic calculation. Now we're going to introduce more realistic elements. Let's say you're ready to buy a house and you have $20,000 for a down payment. Closing costs are estimated to be 4% of the loan value, and you make $36,000 per month, and the bank is willing to give you a mortgage that is equal to about 28% of your income. So this is actually a relatively realistic number of what a mortgage broker will use. We know that the interest rate on the loan is 6% per year and it is a 30-year fixed rate loan. So the question that we want to ask is how much money would the bank loan you? And also, how much can you afford for the house? So that's a lot of information. So I encourage you to either print this slide out or pause and write this down, write all this information down. Okay, so let's take a look at all this information and see how we can address the two questions that we ask. So first, it asks how much money will the bank loan me? So we know that the bank is gonna loan us 28% of my monthly income. So let's first take a look at that. What is our monthly income? So we know that we make $36,000 per year. So divide that by 12, that will give us our monthly income. So we make about $3,000 per month. Next, we know that the bank is gonna loan us an amount up to 28% of my monthly income. So the mortgage payment that the bank is willing to loan to me is 28%. So 28% is 0.28 of my monthly income of $3,000. So in other words, the bank will loan us up to a loan amount that carries a payment of up to $840 per month. So that's really the important information for the bank. So when you talk to your bank, they look at your monthly income, they figure out how much they will be willing to loan you as a percentage of your monthly income. Now we can compute the loan amount. So what do we need to compute the loan amount? Remember that the loan amount is typically the present value. So we are really looking at the present value. If you look at the mortgage on the timeline looks something like this. This is a monthly mortgage, so the timeline is on a monthly basis. We know that this is going to be a 30-year loan with monthly compounding. So 30 years, 12 months per year, we will have to make a total of 360 payments for this entire loan. The bank is going to loan us at an interest rate of 6% per year. So 6% per year, again, we have to make payment on a monthly basis. So that's about, that it actually turns out to be exactly 0.5% per month. And we know what the payment is. We're going to pay the bank $840 every single month for 360 months. And we are looking for the loan amount. So to find the loan amount, we are finding the present value. So let's take a look at that problem. So we have a payment of $840. So again, let's reset the calculator. So 840, that's money we are paying the bank. So we're going to make that our outflow is our payment. This is a 360 months mortgage at an interest rate of 0.5% per month. When we compute our present value, we find that the loan amount that the bank is willing to give us is $140,105. Great, so this is the loan amount. So the bank is going to loan us $104,105. So we have answered this question: how much money would the bank loan me? Next question asks us, how much can I afford for the house? Can I offer for the house? So we have other money that we need to take into account. We said we have a closing cost, which is about 4% of the loan value. So this is our loan amount. And we know our closing cost. So our closing cost is 4%. So 4% is 0.04 times the loan amount of $140,105. So closing cost turns out to be $5,604, so 4% of our loan amount. Finally, we know that we have $20,000 for a down payment and closing costs. So we need to put down the, so our down payment, since we have $20,000, and we know that closing cost is $5,604. So that reduces our down payment, the amount that we have available to put down as down payment, to $20,000 minus $5,604. So we only have $14,396 left that we can use towards down payment. So if we can take out a loan for $140,105 and we have a down payment of $14,396, so together our purchasing power, the amount of money that we can afford, so the total price that we can afford to offer is the sum of these two. So you'll be the $140,000 plus $14,396. So including the loan and the down payment altogether, you can afford to offer a price of $154,501. So notice that the financial or the finance part of this problem involve finding the loan amount. So this is the finance problem. The rest of the problem is really common sense. So we want to walk through how much the closing cost is and then what can you afford to offer. That represents the combination of the money that the bank give you, so that's the loan amount, and the money that you have saved yourself, which is the down payment amount. Okay, so this is a good extended problem that helped you practice combining all the tools that you have learned about annuity and also a more realistic example of finance.